The invention of AC generation stemmed from the vision of scientist Michael Faraday, who simply saw a magnet and a coil and drew from it the discovery of electromagnetic induction. Today, with electricity indispensable in our lives and hopefully to reach communities worldwide soon, solving this challenge of sustainable electricity generation is one of the modern day challenges. Now, photovoltaic or PV technology may be an answer to that problem. We've figured out how to convert solar energy into electricity. However, geographically, the place where solar irradiance is the highest also happens to be where tropical storms frequent, making it very difficult to get a strong signal. Now, our first guests this morning are tackling this exact challenge in Singapore. This island nation off the southern tip of the Malaysian Peninsula is a mere 85 miles north of the equator, fraught with frequent cloud cover. Now, to show us how they're using the graphical system design approach to improve the viability of solar energy, please join me in welcoming project manager Andre Nobre and Mark Kubis, certified LabVIEW architect from the Solar Energy Research Institute of Singapore. Hi, Andre, good to see you. Mark?
Morning, Phil.
Welcome.
Thank you, Shelley, for having us here today. SERIS focuses its research on solar photovoltaic cells, modules, systems, and energy-efficient buildings which are tailored specifically for these harsh tropical environments we find around the world. One of our research projects is geared towards predicting cloud formations and movement ahead of time, and we do that with several different prediction horizons, ranging from a couple of minutes up to several hours ahead in intraday and day ahead forecasts. Now, in order to achieve our research goals, we have deployed a comprehensive network of meteorological stations across Singapore. And just to give the audience an idea, Singapore is about 700 square kilometers in size, which is slightly bigger than Austin here in Texas. All our stations are running on compact rio-based systems, and we have distributed evenly these stations across the island on a 5 by 5 kilometer grid.
Yeah, I think this grid and this diagram gives us a really good idea of the system. Now, Andre, why is it important to predict the weather in these PV applications?
Well, Shelley, with the massive growth of renewable energy utilization worldwide, especially solar PV energy, it is only a matter of time before photovoltaics start contributing considerably towards energy matrices around the world. Therefore, it is very important that utility providers are able to predict the amount of solar electricity which is going to be pumped into the grid so that they can adjust by increasing or decreasing the power, the conventional power generation from these fossil fuel sources. And we need to do all that in real time, irrespective of changing irradiance conditions.
Well, that makes a lot of sense. So if we can better predict the weather and increase the use of these PV applications, we can lower our dependence on the traditional power generation. Now, Mark, I know you are a certified LabVIEW architect. Can you share with us why you chose LabVIEW for this application?
First, because I know LabVIEW for over 20 years, but I think this is the best programming language for this to develop this kind of system. We use LabVIEW to collect synchronized measurements from all our monitoring stations. Then we transfer the data back over 3G network to our lab, where we could accurately develop a model of how weather patterns affect PV systems output. To do these measurements, we need a set of tools. And actually, LabVIEW provides us with a comprehensive set of tools to do all the hardware interfacing, I/O inputs, networking, data transfer, and more, all in one package.
Yeah, that certainly sounds like the power of a complete software platform. But with all of those sensors and all of the data that you're collecting, it sounds like a tremendous amount of data, perfect for NIDIADEM software.
That's right. DIADEM is actually the best tool for us to analyze and visualize large data sets. Here we've uploaded one day of irradiance data from Singapore, from all our monitoring stations into DIADEM. And we can visualize the changing irradiance over the entire island using a contour map with interpolated sensor values. You should see it on the screen right now.
Now, Andre also mentioned earlier that you use Compact Rio hardware in the system.
Yes, I just want to add that aside from this, we also use Doppler radar images from National Environment Agency of Singapore to compute our predictions and to find out the expected contributions from PV systems to the power grid.
Can you tell us about that Compact Rio use too?
Compact Rio, why Compact Rio? All of our stations use Compact Rio. They take synchronized measurements every second, and we manage to synchronize all our remote stations within plus minus 150 milliseconds using 3G network and our own high precision time server. The ruggedness of Compact Rio makes it a perfect choice for the harsh environmental conditions in Singapore, like high temperatures, very high humidity. And the fact that for the past 2 years, we had less than 1% downtime, never caused by any NI components, is another reason that we use Compact Rio for all our stations.
That's phenomenal. More than 2 years running, over 99% availability, a very reliable control system. Now, I know we'd all like to see the actual system in action, but my guess is with the time difference, there's no sun shining on your solar systems in Singapore right now.
Well, that's right. There's no sunshine right now in Singapore, but I have the next best thing here, which is a scaled-down model of our entire application. As we project storm clouds on the photocells in the model, these two Compact Rios take synchronized measurements of the voltages from the photocells in the model, convert them into irradiance, and you can see live irradiance map, that's how we call it, live irradiance map of Singapore on a screen.
You also get to see the happy clouds. They're the happiest clouds I've ever seen. It's also good to note that the LEDs in the back of this scaled-down model actually represent the traditional power generation systems that Andre discussed, how these PV applications work in conjunction. So again, the hope is that we can lower our dependence on the traditional power and use more and more of these PV applications. Thank you, gentlemen, so much for sharing this application with us.
Thanks,
Shelly. Thank you.
Thank you, Shelly.
Thank you, Mark.